thank you and welcome to my review of Oloibiri. I don't know if you guys have gotten a chance to see it yet. It's been in the cinemas for a number of days now. Oloibiri stars Olu Jacobs and Richard Mofet Damijo, directed by Curtis Graham. I know we don't really know too much about him. I know he's done one or two Christian movies before in the past. Now, Oloibiri has to do with a community inspired by true events in the Niger Delta area of Nigeria, where due to the fact that we've had a lot of foreign investors coming into that community, but yet that community has yet to be really developed, despite it having a lot of environmental challenges like oil spills and all that. Now, the movie centers around two very key characters. One is Gunpowder, being played by Richard Mofet Damijo, who is a militant leader, and Olu Jacobs, who is a sort of like elder statesman in the community. His name is actually called Elder in the movie. Now, the movie has to do with Gunpowder, who is the militant leader, hatching onto this plan to kidnap this foreign investor, played by William Moses, who wants to invest in Nigeria with seemingly good intentions, has come into this country to come and take a look at what is really happening in that community. But now there is a plan now to kidnap him by the militant leader, by IMD, which we've all seen in the previews or the trailer, depending on which one you want to call it. Now, and Olu Jacobs' character, who by some way has this foreign investor's life in his hands per se, and being torn at as to what to do about it. Now, the issue I have with Oloibiri is centers around the story and how it's being told. Now, we know that Oloibiri has to do with the fact that this place has not been developed, this place has not been catered well for by the government or both these foreign investors who have come in, you know. But yet, although the filmmakers have this error of not really, really putting us in that position where we need to really feel for this community. Yes, there's no development. Yes, people are angry. But these things happen too in other communities. What was supposed to set Oloibiri apart from other communities was the fact that, based on oil spills, based on the fact that this is where we get a lot of the country's income from, and yet this community has not yet been developed. It has a lot of environmental, economic challenges, and we don't get to see the impact of what these people are going through. If I was a foreigner and I came into Oloibiri for the first time, or I wanted to see this movie for the first time, I wouldn't really know how to feel, really. It's just like a guy tells you now that his car was burgled or they broke his car, and he was like, "Ah, son, they just broke my car, broke my windshield, shelled the tires and everything." There's a way I would feel, I would be sympathetic to him by the fact that I'm just hearing it, than if I was to actually see it myself, and I would see the car, and I would see how badly the windscreen was broken, how they took out the dashboard and stole the gearbox or anything, you know. There's a difference between that and him just telling me. And I just felt that the movie makers didn't do enough to put us in the position where these people are coming from. I thought they didn't do enough of that. Yeah, there was a scene where a boy wanted to drink from an obviously muddy lake. I mean, you don't need oil spills to tell you that you shouldn't be drinking from that lake. So that's why I thought we had a problem with. Yeah, technically it was okay. It had good cameras, location. The movie makers make use of flashbacks in this movie. I'm not going to talk about that. The only thing I'm just going to say about this is this: just because you're wearing an afro doesn't make it 1956. And that's just where I'll just leave it at. Now, on the characters of this R&D and Olu Jacobs, I have to say that Olu Jacobs, for me, had one of the best characters written for this movie. You can see where he's coming from. The fact that he was in the meeting, per se, in post-independence, where they tried to broker a deal with the foreign investors, and it didn't really go down well. And all of a sudden, he now has the life of this foreigner in his hands. And you can see the conflict with where he's coming from, as in doing the right thing as a human being to save this man's life, and also like to exact his vengeance on these people who he feels have done wrong for him. One of the reasons why I wanted to see him was because of RNG. Now, for the fact that he was playing a militant leader, and you know, it was taking him away from the traditional RND roles that we know. And what do I mean about the RND roles? You know, a well-dressed, well-spoken guy, you know, ladies man kind of person, you know. And I was really excited to see this. But the fact, I felt like they didn't do much to tell us about his character, why he was doing this, how he, what motivated him to come, to become a militant leader. This is someone who is stated that came out with first class with geology. Why all of a sudden has he become a militant leader? Why are his boys even following? What is the motivation behind them being part of this militant group? Is it that they're doing it for money, for work? Is it that they just need an excuse to kill people? We don't really get to see that. His character in the beginning of the movie is kind of like a guy who really loves his community. But then when in the second act of the movie and William Arbus' character comes in, he just turns around all of a sudden. It's a huge deviation from where he's coming from. Remember that series Robin Hood that we used to watch back in the 90s, where Robin Hood is he drinks with the community, eats with them, prays with them, and all of a sudden, just because somebody comes into the community, he starts burning villages, he starts killing people, trekking people all over the place. So for me, it was a bit too much for me. I didn't know what to do about that. And by the time things start to happen, especially in the second and third act of the movie, you don't really know how to feel for that. You don't know what emotion to give to that. The support cast for me, you don't really do much. William Moses is okay. Thankfully, he doesn't seem like that kind of guy who just wants to come and pick up a paycheck. He's okay based on what the kind of dialogue and story that surrounds him. But for me, the standout person for this movie has to be Evie Okujie. I think she's fantastic in this movie. I think she stands out. She really gives a believable performance. When she's scared, you really fear for her. Let her not go and kill this girl. Oh, when she's doing what she does, she, for me, outshines any other person that she is on screen with as this movie goes on. And I really cannot wait for her to be our next breakout star internationally. And when I say international, I don't mean that they know her in Ghana. I mean like Hollywood international. But unfortunately, even what she does cannot carry this movie. There are so many things that they're supposed to touch on that will really make you feel patriotic, even if it's for a day, or feel the sense of nationalism that, oh, Nigeria, we need to get things right. But unfortunately, it doesn't do that. And I'll say for me, over 5 stars, I'll have to give Oloibiri 2.5. Trust me, I really, really wanted to like this movie, but it doesn't really put you in that state of self-empathy or whatever it is that you want to feel at the end of the day. In fact, you coming out of the cinema, instead of you thinking about that, you'll be like, Chelsea just beat Man U 4-0. Do you understand? People were actually hissing at the end of the day. But whatever it is, man, if you think maybe I'm too harsh and it was a Nollywood classic, please comment below, let us know. And please stay blessed. Thank you.